Dr. Zia. I'm a clinical psychologist specializing in transgender care. Welcome to my channel. Let's discuss today the fears that you're experiencing about others abandoning you as a result of transitioning. That could be either your partners, that could be your family members, it could be your friends, it could be other people in your life. So these fears that other people are going to abandon you, they're going to leave you if you decide to undergo a transition. This is a very, very big fear. This is one of the most dominant fear for anybody who identifies as transgender, for anybody who decides to either even come out in social transition or come out and surgically, medically transition. This fear that you're going to be left alone, that people are going to leave you, is a really, really big one. And because we're social creatures, because we are human beings who crave intimacy and contact and relationship, and we don't exist in a vacuum, all of those things first make the fear blow out even bigger out of proportion. So I want to talk to you today about this fear and maybe give you some of the ways you can deal with that fear. In my experience working as a psychologist, I find that fears of abandonment that people tend to experience usually falls into kind of two things within ourselves. One is that you actually had an experience of people abandoning you in the past. You had an experience of people leaving you in the past. And I'm not talking about relationships ending where it was mutual and it didn't work out for you. I'm talking about where you had an experience of friends just leaving you. You had an experience of family members leaving you. Or you had an experience of your parents or your partners not being there for you, and hence also feeling and cultivating a sense of abandonment. So that's the first, I would say, first group of people. I hate grouping people into groups, but I think it helps you understand it better. First one would be if you fall into this category where you have a lot of experiences in your life of experiencing abandonment, of experiencing loss. As a result, you have, in a way, created within yourself this defensive function where you're so afraid that it might happen. And when we're usually afraid that something is going to happen, we do the opposites of it. So for you, opposite of that would be now clinging to people in your life, clinging in a sense of holding on to people in your life, making sure that they're not going anywhere, making sure you do everything you can that they won't leave you. So this is one of the reasons why if some of you fall into this category, you're really afraid of abandonment because you have that history of previous abandonment. So it's kind of like self-fulfilling prophecy for you, right? It may feel like that, oh my God, this always happens to me. So if I do this, this is going to happen to me again. And it was so painful to experience this in the past. I don't want to go through this again. I don't want to be alone. I don't want to feel this heartache. And in order not to feel the heartache, I'm going to hold on to these people in my life. And my way of holding on is I'm not going to come out. I'm not going to transition. I'm not going to care about myself. Because if I do, I lose people around myself. Well, here's the double-edged sword here, is that by doing that, you are losing something. In this case, you're losing yourself. So notice how by holding on to people because you're afraid they're going to leave you and not doing anything about transition, you're ultimately losing yourself because you're not doing anything for you. And another thing here is that people always feel when somebody's holding on to them, especially if the clinginess or enmeshment is present. And people, we're all kind of, in a way, are independent in a sense. So people start feeling a little bit suffocation, start feeling a little bit overwhelmed, and then they pull away from you because it's too much for them. So also I want you to notice that if you are clinging, if you are holding on to people, I want you to notice that actually instead of having them come closer to you, you may be pushing them further away. Unfortunately, that's how it works. But the most important thing I want you to notice is that when you are holding on to people because you are afraid that how your decisions about transition is going to affect them, you're losing yourself. And it's double-edged sword. And in my book, I don't think it's worth ever to lose yourself. I don't believe in this concept that you need to sacrifice yourself for the happiness of your partner, that you need to sacrifice yourself for the happiness of your family. Sacrificing yourself for the happiness of others comes in different forms and shapes. It's not sacrifice, it comes more as a compromise. In this case, when you're struggling with gender dysphoria, that is not a compromise. When you're struggling with gender dysphoria, that is a sacrifice, because gender dysphoria can really ultimately destroy your life, literally and psychologically and emotionally and on so many other different levels. So, but that's the first part of about the abandonment, is that a group of people that have the experience of experiencing it in the past. The second group of people that tend to fear abandonment when it comes to coming out or making first steps about transition tends to be a group of people who either also had the experience of losing people in the past, but also haven't really established a relationship with themselves, and you are afraid of being alone. You are afraid of being all by yourself. Some people just innately feel fear of being completely alone, right? I want you to notice here something. You can be in the company of somebody else and still feel incredibly alone. This is really, really important, because a lot of times we equate aloneness to me by myself, alone in a room. I am alone, right? Well, I can be in a room by myself and not feel lonely and feel very in solitude within myself and really enjoy the company of myself. That means I have a really strong relationship with myself. For some of you, it's very difficult to cultivate relationship with yourself, because yourself is also not kind of fragmented, if you will, because gender dysphoria is present. So there's a lot about yourself that has been in a way not really integrated yet. So this is why it may be very challenging for you. But I want you still to notice how a lot of times people say, I don't want to transition because then I'm going to end up being alone. When if I were to ask some of you, well, are you now in the company of somebody else? And you would say, yeah, I have my partner. And if I were to say, well, do you feel connected? Do you feel alone with your partner? Some of you will actually say, even though I'm with my partner, I feel so lonely and so incredibly alone. So notice how a presence of another human being in your life, in other words, doesn't necessarily mean that you're not alone. You can be incredibly lonely in the company of many. So that's another group of people that I see fear abandonment, is that people who haven't really established a relationship with themselves. And for some of you, it might be innate. Some people are just more predisposed to being in a company of people. And some people are just really more predisposed being completely alone, and they thrive on solitude within themselves, and that's okay too. So those are the two categories. You may find yourself in one or other category. You might yourself to be in a combination of the two. But because of those life experiences and lack of relationship to yourself, the fear of abandonment is going to be really be forefront. For a lot of people who are transitioning, who have not had a lot of experiences of losses of other people in their lives, who, in other words, who have not had a lot of experiences of abandonment and have good relationship to themselves, I rarely see those people being afraid that they might lose somebody, because they're confident that either, it's not that, you know, guys, it's not that the fear of losing others doesn't enter their mind. It does. It's just that because they had such positive relationship experiences in the past with other people and lack of abandonment, they also know that they can always cultivate new relationships. So they're always also optimistic about making new relationships. And that's what makes it all different. The mindset plays a huge, huge part into it. One of the things about this fear of abandonment and putting you in this position of, again, paralysis, of fearing to make decision about your transition, is that what you have to realize is fear of abandonment is one of the things that if you have it, it's not just going to go away by itself. One of the best ways to actually deal with abandonment is to trust people, and which makes it incredibly, incredibly difficult for a lot of you, because how can you trust somebody when you have history of abandonment? You have history of things happening a particular way, and now you're supposed to trust that it's not going to happen this way. That's what makes it so, so difficult. But fear of abandonment, in my opinion, really gets resolved when you start trusting somebody, and life proves to you that not everybody's going to abandon. There's going to be people who are always going to be with you, and that starts cultivating a trust within, and then abandonment diminishes. When it comes to transition, and if you are in a place in your life where you want to transition, or you want to come out, or you want to do anything about your gender, but you're really, really fearing abandonment, I want you just to think about how you're abandoning in this instance yourself. And I want you to ask yourself whether it's worth it to abandon yourself. Now, to each its own. I can only say what matters to me. And like I said, to me, abandonment of yourself is not worth it, but that's me. For you, it may be a different matter. So you have to do what's best for you. But I just want you to ask yourself those questions, because, you know, you may be staying with somebody and at the same time feel incredibly lonely and disconnected to them too, and that's important to know too. So it's not really so much the quantities of people in our lives, but the quality of this relationship in our lives. So think about that. But unfortunately, fear of abandonment is a big one. It's not an easy way to get over it. There's not an easier, quicker solution to jump through it. And the biggest aspect of it is being able to also have a relationship with yourself and learning how to be okay to be alone and how it is all right to be by yourself. Again, we're also living in a Western culture where being alone is not considered to be a good thing. In fact, if you go to a restaurant and have a table for one and have a dinner by yourself, a lot of people feel very uncomfortable doing that, or going to a movie theater and watching a movie by yourself, because we live in a culture where you have to go with somebody. You can't do this social coupled experiences by yourself, which is absolutely not true. So you want to kind of also challenge yourself to do those things, and that will help you have a relationship with yourself. So hopefully this was helpful. I'm sorry, I know that I did not give you guys really good solutions or options, but this is one of those things that are really challenging to deal. So if you're afraid of losing somebody as a result of transition, the biggest thing I can offer you is just to ask yourself whether you're going to lose yourself and how important that is to you. You know, what people in our lives are going to leave us no matter what, one way or another. They will leave us because one day we all do essentially die. That is just a fact. Or they may leave us because down the road, the relationship with us is not going to be something that's going to be a benefit to them, and then you're going to be left with these years of your life when you could have done something about your gender and your dysphoria, and you could have transitioned in the time period, but you didn't. You were holding on to this relationship, but ultimately it didn't work out. So just think about all of those things, because you really want to do what's best for you. Comment below, let me know if you're right now in a position where you want to transition, but this fear of abandonment is paralyzing you, it's holding you back. Let me know why it's holding you back. Let me know if you ask yourself whether you're abandoning yourself and how that feels. And if you have been there, you have been in that obstacles, share with others how you were able to move through that obstacle. Share with others what was able to help you, because we all read each other's comments. So comment below, let me know, and I will see you guys all next time. Bye.